हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू स्टूडेंट्स? यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम इन दिस नेक्स्ट वीडियो. दिस इज द वीडियो सीरीज ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 5, प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस एंड वेरिएशन. सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द क्रोमोसोमल थ्योरी ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस. वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ वन जीन, इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ टू जीन. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द क्रोमोसोमल थ्योरी ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस. सो बिफोर डिस्कसिंग इट, आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस विद यू अबाउट द मेंडल. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, मेंडल परफॉर्म द एक्सपेरिमेंट टिल 7 ईयर. ओके, 7 ईयर was the experimental period of Mendel on pea plant. From 1856 to 1863, Mendel performed the experiment on pea plant. And his conclusion was published, and he published his work in 1865. So in 1865, he published, but the work of Mendel was not appreciated by the International Union of the Scientists. Why? Dear students, actually Mendel have performed the experiment on pea plant, and he given the hypothesis of factor. So that factor practically Mendel did not prove the what is factor and how it is going. So this was the concept of Mendel, the factor. So that was not accepted. And also alleles are blended in F1 generation and are separated in F2 generation. This was also not accepted by the Union of Scientists. Okay, so that is why, dear students, the Mendel work is still was not appreciated till 1900s. Okay, so in 1900 there was three scientists. I am writing here the three scientists. They re-experimented the experiments of Mendel. Okay, so Mendel have performed the experiment on pea plant, and these three scientists independently re-experimented on the work of Mendel. Okay, and they concluded the same that Mendel has concluded earlier. So dear students, here these three scientists, they make the concepts, or they make the hypothesis, or the conclusion of the Mendel as the Mendel's law. So we all know that the Mendel's law of dominance, law of segregation, and law of independent assortment, these are the law after the re-experimentation of the Hugo de Vries, Karl Korens, and Tessermak. Okay, earlier only these law was in the form of hypothesis. Got it? So here in 1900, Mendel's work was appreciated through these three scientists, and they made they given the credit to Mendel of their re-experimentation, because Mendel have given the idea about the genetics that was incredible. Okay, so that is why, due to these three scientists, Mendel is known as the father of genetics. Got it? So now let's discuss about, dear students, these three scientists have experimented on pea plant as well as on different plants and animals. Okay, and they found the conclusion that something as Mendel and little bit as different or varies from the Mendel's concept. Got it? So now let's discuss, dear students, the scientists. These were two scientists, Sutter and Woveri. They discovered, or they given the chromosomal theory of inheritance. They told that because in Mendel's time there was no microscopy, that is why Mendel's work is practical work, but little bit that was the hypothetical. Got it? So that is why the work of Mendel, it was not fully practical. So after the discovery of microscope, Sutton and Woveri and these three scientists, they concluded and they find out and they discovered that how the Mendel's factor is working. Because through the microscope, the scientists were able to see the cell division and how it is happened in different cells. So you know, you have also studied in class 11th the cell division, mitosis and meiosis. So in mitosis cell division, there is no destruction or there is no reduction of the number of chromosome, but in meiosis cell division, the number of chromosomes are reduced to half to their parental cell. Okay, So here Sutter and Boveri observed the factor of Mendel and they concluded that the factor of Mendel has two allele or the one gene has two allele on different homologous chromosome and at the time of gametogenesis two homologous chromosomes are separated from the two set and each homologous chromosome contains one allele. So that is why in one gamete one allele is present because it has the one set of chromosome. How it is happen? It will be clear more through this diagram. Dear students, they concluded that in cell cycle there are stages G1 stage, S stage, G2 stage and M phase. Okay, so these are mainly four stages. G0 also is found, but we are discussing about these four: G1, S and G2 and then M phase. So here in G1 phase and G2 phase, so the number of chromosome, suppose the number of chromosome is 4 in a cell. Okay, so here suppose this is the cell and number of chromosome are 4, two bigger one and two smaller one. So here suppose these are the chromosome we are discussing here. So these are chromosome, one I am making it shaded, okay, and another one is without shade. So here is another chromosome, this is the shaded chromosome. Okay, so these are the four chromosome in a cell. Dear students, in G1 stage these are in the form of two set. Okay, because one set of chromosome is this is first set and this is second set. Okay, so in first set two chromosome are present, one is bigger one and one is smaller, and in second set also one is bigger and one is smaller. So these two bigger, which are similar in size and similar in structure, are known as homologous chromosome. Here these are another pair of homologous chromosome. Okay, so homologous chromosome means one chromosome in first set and one chromosome in second set, and these remains in pair. Okay, so that is why these are the homologous chromosome. So in G2 phase these, okay, so this is darker one and this is remaining one is, or remaining pair is unshaded. Okay, so these are like this. So in M phase, now this is the M phase we are discussing here. So in M phase, I am writing M phase, G2 this one and M phase this. So here, dear students, you are looking, the spindle fiber is formed like this here also. Okay, so this is meiosis first. M first I am writing. What does happen in meiosis first? The chromosome which is separated like this, so one set of chromosome is reaching in this cell and one set of chromosome reaching in this cell. Like this, okay. So here in meiosis second, what happens? So in meiosis second, because here also a spindle fiber is formed, so what happens in meiosis second and what results in meiosis second? What happens, dear students? Here now this tetrad of chromosome of this pair is separated, or splitting of chromosome occurs. Okay, so here we are looking, so like this, these are the shaded one, like this and this. Okay, so here, and also this separated now, okay? So here, you know, the gene which is present at the one chromosome, okay? So like this, this is the chromosome. So gene is found, one gene is present here. So the similar gene is present on the another chromosome of homologous pair, like this. So this is also present at another chromosome. So the two chromosomes which are similar in structure, similar in shape, and similar in size are known as what? Are known as homologous chromosome. So the two form of one gene are present on the homologous chromosome is known as allele. So you know, these are two alleles of one gene. Okay, suppose gene A is found. So this one A1 and A2. So these are two form of gene A. That is why these two form of gene A are known as allele of gene A. Got it? So here these two allele are present here in a single cell. And in G2 phase also these two allele are present, still present in a single cell. But now when meiosis first is started, these two alleles are separated now. Okay? So one here, because one allele is present at the shaded chromosome. So here one A1 is reached here, and second one A2 is reached here. And also in result of meiosis second, so this is the result of meiosis second. So you are looking here in meiosis second, these A1, okay, so A1 reached here and also here, because one chromosome, it makes the copy after splitting. So these are the two copy of this one. So that is why here A1, here A2 and A2. So four gametes are formed, and these four gametes having the two type of allele of gene A. Got it? So that is why this is proving that how genes are inherited in next generation, how genes are passing in next step of or next generation of the cell in cell division. When the chromosome reaches in next generation of the cell, then the gene or allele is present or found on the that chromosome, it is also reached in next generation. So that is why with the help of chromosome, it is proved that Mendel's factor is working, okay? And Mendel's factor is reached with the chromosome in next generation of cell. Got it? So here this is the first generation and this is the second generation of cell. Got it? This is about the chromosomal theory of inheritance. Okay? Sutter and Boveri proved this. So also we will prove that how the law of independent assortment works with the help of chromosomal theory of inheritance in next video. This is enough for this video. Dear students, I hope you are understanding the concept. If any doubt, question, you can ask me on personal WhatsApp number. Thank you for watching it.